बैंगन है, भिंडी है, आलू है। तुम ओलंपिक्स में गए हो, शादी में गए हो।
द ग्रेटेस्ट शो ऑन प्लैनेट अर्थ, द ओलंपिक्स आर रेडी टू बिगिन। And since Jaggu and I are not really well versed with all the sporting action in the world, we have found a resident expert. Rahul Rawat is a fantastic sports journalist, decades in the business. He works for the India Today Group, the Aaj Tak Group, and he is currently in Tokyo. And very sweetly, he has made time for both Jaggu and me and you to take us through all the action and tell us what to expect, how many medals can India expect, what the scene is, what the COVID restrictions are. We're very pleased that Amara, like, aankho dekha hal batane ke liye Rahul Rawat is ready. Rahul, thank you very much for doing this. We can't believe our luck that we have found you to take our viewer and us through, you know, what is going to be the most fantastic show on planet Earth. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Tarana ji. In fact, it's a pleasure to be on your show. And I can't believe my luck to be on your show with you. And I mean, bilkul. And I'm being honest. And secondly, unprecedented Olympic Games. I think Moscow 1980, we had one. And we all know what happened during that Moscow Olympics. A lot of people countries boycotted, but this time Olympics, you know, there's a sense of, there is something that you can feel around. You know, when I landed at the airport yesterday, I could sense something that these are not going to be those usual games, the festivities that usually are happened around these type of events. We've seen Commonwealth Games in India itself. And, you know, the kind of festivities around, there is something missing. You know,
the buzz is missing.
The sense of fear, exactly. That buzz is missing.
You know, I wanted to just, before we get to the events itself, like you were saying, you landed about 24 hours ago. What is the protocol there like? I'm sure the issues start at the airport itself.
Absolutely. You know, I was prepared because we had spoken to a lot of people who landed earlier or much before we came to Tokyo. But before that, what the organizing committee will make you do is they will make you go through hundreds and thousands of pages of documents. And then if you falter somewhere, they would say it was mentioned in that particular document, in that particular page. And you have to be very precise with what you are doing. So sure. You have to get yourself, earlier the guideline said that before departure from India, if you are from India, they had specific restrictions and protocols for people coming from 11 odd countries. And India, unfortunately,
is one of them.
Happened to be, one of those countries. So earlier pre-departure, you had to get tested 7 times. That means every day. Fortunately, later they relaxed it a bit and said that you can actually have a test 96 hours before your departure and then 72 hours before your departure. So that is what I took. And then you have to have those a few of those health apps. Because those health apps, what they are going to do is they are also going to monitor where you are moving around.
Correct.
In the city when you land in Tokyo. So that
Fair
is
enough.
The name of that app is Ocha. I used to call it Oka. It was then I realized when I landed at the airport that these volunteers told me, "Do you have Ocha?" I said, "Yaar, Ocha to main khud hi hoon. Main kya rakhunga Ocha?" Khair, anyways. So Ocha app jo hai, you need to have that. Uska wo hai. Then your Arogya Setu's Japanese brother Cocoa app.
Cocoa.
That also you need to have. Hamara Arogya Setu is their Japanese version is Cocoa. So anyways, so wo hai. So as it had to happen, Ocha chala nahi. Usne apna naam ke jaise apna kaam bhi kiya. Mera chala nahi. And didn't happen with me, just with me, but with each and everybody. So we landed here, something happened, they took our phones and we just somehow managed to get past all those protocols that there. Then I realized when I stepped into my hotel, then I realized that I was lucky that I finished all that process in about 3.5 hours, because a few of the journalists who are staying, foreign journalists, for somebody from America, from Belgium, from Ecuador, from Italy, the Euro champions. So I asked them, how much time did it take? Somebody said 6 hours. Somebody said 5 hours. So then I realized, Bhagwan, आज मुझे पता लगा कि मैं हमेशा बोलता था कि मेरे साथ ही मुझे को इतना struggle क्यों करना पड़ता है. Then I realized कि यार I got lucky this time maybe.
Hey, anybody interesting on the flight with you?
Jagu.
Sorry?
Anybody interesting on the flight with you?
अरे but they're all coming to the Olympics only ना. So some महान हस्ती might have been there.
नहीं महान हस्ती वो सानिया मिर्जा was a महान हस्ती. Then Ankita Raina, her doubles partner, was okay. Another Mahan Hasti with me in the same flight, because majority of the Indian contingent had already arrived here in Tokyo. And baki ke Mahan Hasti mere jaane pehchane chehre the, Indian journalist the, aur mera apna camera person tha, jisko maine bola tu yahan baith, main 1 kilometer peeche jaake baith raha hu, because wahan pe kuch mere colleagues the, Hindustan Times ke some IOA officials, jo Olympics ke officials the, whom I knew before we landed here, उनको पहले से मैं जानता था क्योंकि उनके अगेंस्ट बड़ी सारी स्टोरीज भी करी हैं, कभी कभार अच्छी स्टोरीज भी करी हैं, तो वो भी मुझे जानते हैं. जिनके अगेंस्ट करते थे वो नहीं बात करी उन्होंने फ्लाइट पे, जिनकी करी जिनसे करी थी वो अच्छी कर लेते थे. फ्लाइट खाली थी मुश्किल से. मेरे ख्याल से 3 सेक्शन में भी आप डिवाइड कर दो. बिजनेस क्लास, मैं तो खैर कैटल क्लास में था, और उसके बाद एक और पीछे एक सेक्शन था. हाँ. तो मैं मतलब एक सेक्शन में अराउंड मैंने गिने थे. आई वाज काउंटिंग द नंबर ऑफ पीपल ऑन द फ्लाइट. जर्नलिस्ट हैं तो थोड़ा कभी कभार ये करना पड़ सोच लेते हैं. 12 एक सेक्शन में थे, 9 एक सेक्शन में थे, आई थिंक अराउंड 5 to 8 odd people इन बिजनेस सेक्शन. सो कुल मिला के I think on that entire flight, not more than 30 to 35 people but came that, from India too.
But that must have made you feel definitely more secure about being on a plane for that many hours and going to the Olympics. You were like, the last thing you want to do is fall sick on the plane or catch something on the plane and then not be able to cover the Olympics. So good that they, you know, you were able to social distance and all. Now, you know, we want to ask you, ye Olympics pichle saal hone wale the, COVID ki wajah se they were delayed. Are the athletes happy that they are indeed finally taking place even though ek saal delay ho gaya hai? Or are they like, yaar, hamari 4 saal ki training thi and now everything is gadbad because we had to also be locked at home and we couldn't train. So maybe it would be better if it were delayed further or just cancelled. What are the athletes feeling?
I think further delay ka to ab koi option reh nahi gaya hai, because this was the agreement is such that it could have max to max, they could have hosted or staged this event this year in 2021, because that is how the agreement was, because 2020, as you said, it was supposed to happen, scheduled to happen last year. But there are always pros and cons to each and everything. See, for example, today, Tarana, if I ask you people, in fact, if I ask you people, do you think Sindhu is a medal prospect? I think you would say yes, maybe. Imagine Neeraj Chopra from athletics, that javelin thrower. Everybody is saying that perhaps he'll be the first Indian to win an Olympic medal in track and field. Today, everybody. Last year, he was injured. He had an elbow surgery, so he wouldn't have participated. So there is, of course, these are the pros. You know, you have two prospects, to bright medal prospect in these Olympics. But last year, and a lot of people are from around the world are not participating also. For some, it'll be good. You know, maybe the field is a little weaker. But yes, a lot of athletes had to go through a lot of things. For example, I would tell you about Bajrang. I was speaking to him before we came here. So Bajrang, during this lockdown,
the wrestler, Bajrang Punia is a wrestler, and yes, he's in 65 kilo, yes, just for audio viewer.
Absolutely. Yes. So
he didn't have a sparring partner.
He competes as So he did have a sparring partner, but he didn't have somebody from his weight category. So he was his sparring partner was another wrestler. He competes in 75 kg. So wherever he would go, if he would go to his house, Bajrang, he would take him. If he would go to camp, he would take him. So, and it is difficult. See, imagine if I ask you to compete and train with somebody who's in a higher category, it's actually a little difficult because there is a scope of risk of injury also.
Plus
the kind of technique that you would employ or apply against
a heavier
wrestler
person
of his own weight category or a heavier person may not work. So these are the kind of struggles. And you know, javelin thrower Neeraj, for example, we are talking about. Imagine they were training in Patiala because they couldn't go out of the country or do anything. So your walkers, everybody, or maybe you know, athletics, everybody was training in Patiala, and you can imagine the kind of heat under which they were training. So this lockdown last 1.5 years have been actually for them. I think it is better ki Olympics ho raha hai, get it out of your system. Jisko jeetna hai, he will win. She will win. Because 4 years they've worked really, really hard to get to here.
You know, so before we get into more of the specifics, there's this actually a two-point thing. I picked up a piece of information recently that starting like modern Olympics, 1896 mein toh shuru hua tha, India's in whatever form was sending contingents from 1900 onwards. So 1900 to 2016, we have won 28 medals. Then I read this other article by Vikram Limsey. He writes in the ET. His point was that it was quite interesting. Now, he's not a sports person. He's a management consultant. So, he has a whole different perspective. Ki, medal tallies sometimes or quite often coincide with size of economy. Now, that has to do with the amount of money that they invest in sports, this, that, and the other, which is why US and China, you will always find them high on the medal tally because they have the largest economies in the world. Japan is an outlier downwards. Great economy, but they don't win as many medals.
Australia
is not fair enough. But that's also true for Australia. Australia mein situation alag hai. Economy is not that big, but always high on the medal tally thing. So it's a sporting nation. And then there's that whole juxtaposition to the Indian medal tally. So far in the last 116 years, we won 28 medals. But we've been winning, well, more in the recent past than we have in the distant past.
Right.
And our economy is growing. So, based on that comparison, as it were, how do you think we'll perform these Olympics as well as aage jaake?
I also, in fact, he has, just given us a lowdown, as you said, in figures. But it's a question that we ask every year from perhaps we ask this question to everybody that, you know, why don't we win these many medals? Why do we just end up with, 4 medals, 5 medals, 6 medals that we won, 6 medals we won in London? That's our best haul so far. So we ask this. But then eventually, we need to know what our priorities actually are. So that way, even I agree. 96 Atlanta Olympics, it was a huge gap after almost 52 Helsinki. KD Jadhav won a medal, bronze medal in wrestling, and the next individual medal that we got was in 96. Still, I think kitna hamara budget kitna hai is saal sarkar ne hame kitna budget diya every year jo mere khayal se, I think around 1100 crores
usse kya hoga
round about that. So,
is that enough or not enough? I don't know.
Not enough.
Absolutely not. Absolutely. Not enough. There was China in 1980s. Where was China? There was China before 1980. China was nowhere to be seen. Today, when they compete, they have just one goal, that we have to end up ahead of US right at the top of the medals tally. You know, Beijing Olympics was where China wanted to showcase what we are capable of. They spent a hell lot of money in organization of that Olympics, and they ensured that we win, that they win more medals than Americans, and of course then they end up so that they end up at the top of the. So priorities, we are, see, we be it cricket, even cricket, I would say, be it any sport, we are sportsman loving, sportsperson loving nation. Sania Mirza, Mahesh Bhupathi, Leander Pace, that's it. What is the next line of, what is the next crop of tennis players you have?
You say, we love the stars, we don't really love the sport.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You guys tell me, I would say, even cricketer for that matter, cricketers, you would get to know, hear about these stories. Virat Kohli is the highest paid Indian athlete for this Instagram. On Instagram, he charges around 5-6 crores for every Insta post. But even though I don't, these are what you get to hear. This was actually this is by Forbes, not by me.
Okay.
Even though I would say that he doesn't charge that much money. I don't think so.
Okay.
he doesn't 6 crores. Yeah, aise thodi na. But what about others? Do you yesterday Deepak Chahar, if you've seen that second,
but he did ODI, very well. Yeah, I mean the second ODI,
he did really well. Huh. He did really well. How much do you think he must be earning? Not he gets his match fees, contracts, everything. But is he making the same kind of money that perhaps a Virat Kohli or maybe a Rohit Sharma or even a Sachin Tendulkar or a MS Dhoni? You know,
No. 10%.
There is a huge disparity, and that is why it's for me. If you say Chinese players, they come this Olympics, you might not see them in the next Olympics. You might not see them in the third Olympics. Mary Kom. In 2012, London Olympics, she got a bye in the first round. She won two bouts. She won her next two bouts. Quarterfinal, semi-final, she faced a young boxer from England, Nicola Adams. You know, very promising at that time. And it seemed, she won that bout fair and square, hands down. Today, where is Nicola Adams? Nicola Adams is
retired.
Has quit boxing. Yes, that's it. She's done. She has done what she wanted to do. Now she's away from the sport. So, but you still have Mary Kom. I am not saying that there is a dearth of competitors or boxers in the country. I'm just giving you an example. If today also you have to rely on somebody,
rely on a
Leander Pace, on a Mary Kom, on a Sania Mirza, So then, as a sporting nation, maybe you have not progressed that much. You won't see these kind of things in China, perhaps, because they prepare for the next Olympics. Next Olympics, they would say, no, this is the girl. We are going to
nurture her and
she's going to
guide her and give her the perfect training.
And nothing wrong with, as far as, let me make it very clear, there is nothing wrong as far as Leander Pace, Mary Kom and Sania Mirza are concerned, because they are doing what they know best.
Yeah.
If there is no challenger who can actually replace them, it is not their fault.
No.
Unfortunately,
they're just at the top of their game consistently.
Yes. Unfortunately, maybe it is a fault of the system, if I may say so.
Yeah, I entirely agree with you.
But on a more optimistic note, this year is supposedly a really good Olympics for the Indian contingent. We've sent our largest contingent. I think there are 119 athletes that are competing. And
128 it is now.
It is now. Okay. And apparently...
Wait. I have a question. Before we get into the athletes itself, 128 athletes... out of a total contingent of about 235?
Yeah, about 228.
वो बाकी 100 क्या कर रहे
हैं? Support staff जब
वो उन्होंने support staff भी है उसमें coaches भी हैं इस बार तो खैर उसपे भी बहुत restrictions हैं the number of people that you can carry or you can tag along with उसपे भी है support staff भी है besides officials भी हैं. So, उसमें ऐसा भी होता है. For example, आप चले गए, आपने कहा कि जी मेरा दीपिका कुमारी, that archer is your, you, आप उसके official हैं या उसकी federation से हैं, archery federation से हैं या उसके coach हैं, उसके physio हैं, या फिर उसके वो क्या साइकोलॉजिस्ट हैं जो भी हैं वो भी जा सकते हैं. फिर क्या होता है आपका इवेंट खत्म हो जाता है, देन यू कैन कम बैक. वो आपका वो उसके बाद उन्होंने आपका जो पास था अक्रेडिटेशन था वो तराना जी को ट्रांसफरेबल है. वो तराना जी चली जाएंगी उसमें बिकॉज देन शी वुड से कि यार मेरे मैं तो बजरंग की कोच हूँ. हाँ मैं बजरंग की कोच हूँ तो मैं बजरंग के साथ चलेगी. सो दैट इज वो ट्रांसफरेबल होता है. सो वो फिगर ज्यादा हो गया.
बट दिस टाइम दे आर ऑल रेलेवेंट, दे आर नॉट द हैंगर्स.
इस बार टू अ ग्रेट एक्सटेंट दे आर रेलेवेंट, टू अ ग्रेट एक्सटेंट. हाँ बट नॉट एंटायरली. बट
okay, now we'll come to the 128. What were you saying, Tarana?
No, so I was saying this year apparently at least 10 Indian athletes are in the they're the top 1, 2, 3 in their respective fields. So can we assume at least 10 medals we should get, or is that
why
too
not?
Ambitious?
Why not? No, and what is wrong in being ambitious? I don't think there is anything wrong being ambitious, but we also have to see these are Olympics. So I would, if you ask me, I would also give my figure between 3 or 4 to 10 medals.
Okay.
And I'm sure if you said 10, you would know who your medal prospects are. You know, all these years, but Olympics is a different challenge, and you also have to see. Ho sakta hai, as I said, everything has pros and cons. This time you won't have the crowd, so maybe the Indians or the Indians would say, "Yar, chalo acha hai." Kabhi kabhi aisa hota na. The occasion gets the better of you. Aap Olympics mein compete kar rahe hain, wahan crowd hai, and you realize, "Yar, I'm at the Olympics." Just closer to the to a final or somewhere, you just falter at the wrong time. So ho sakta hai wo, but that would apply to all the other countries also.
Yeah.
So wo hai, but if you ask me, आपका मेरे मेडल प्रोस्पेक्ट सौरभ फर्स्ट शूटिंग से अगर आप बोले आई थिंक मिक्स्ड इवेंट शूटिंग में आपका एयर राइफल एंड एयर पिस्टल. एयर राइफल में यू कैन विन मिक्स्ड इवेंट में मेन एंड वेमेन दोनों कंबाइन करके. एयर राइफल यू हैव अ वेरी गुड टीम एंड एज यू ऑलरेडी नो मनु भाकर एंड सौरभ चौधरी वो दोनों जब मिलेंगे इंडिविजुअली सौरभ चौधरी इज फैंटास्टिक. ही इज डन, ही इज बीन वेरी कंसिस्टेंट इन द लास्ट 3 years. एंड सो तीन मेडल ये हो गए आपके शूटिंग से. मीराबाई चानू ऑन द वेरी फर्स्ट डे इज वेरी मच केपेबल ऑफ विनिंग अ मेडल एंड यू नो व्हाई द एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड एल्गोरिथम उसका जो है. एंड मीराबाई चानू उसके बाद आर्चरी में दीपिका कुमारी इज गोइंग टू पेयर अप विद हर हस्बैंड तानु दास. लास्ट टू टाइम्स शी इज फॉल्टर्ड. डोंट नो व्हाट हैपेंस दिस टाइम बट मे बी उसमें भी आपका चांस है. पांच आपके मेडल्स ये हो गए. उसके बाद पीवी सिंधु यू ऑलरेडी नो, बजरंग पुनिया यू ऑलरेडी नो, विनेश आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग हर टू गेट अ मेडल. तो ये कितने हो गए, 8 मेडल्स ये हो गए.
She is number one, exactly. Isn't she?
Fogart,
Vinesh Fogart is doing very well.
Yes. Then aapke boxing se Mary Kom and Amit Pangal is also world number one. Ye aapke ho gaye 10 medals, 10 medal ye ho gaye. And then you have your Neeraj Chopra.
Javelin.
Jiski hum baat kar rahe the athletics mein. So ye 11 medals ho gaye aapke. Aap 10 ki baat kar rahe hain. Maine 11 ginwa diye. But baat yahi hoti hai ki isme se medals mein kitne translate honge. To बाकी आप अपना ऊपर नीचे देख लीजिए भाव.
हॉकी टीम इज आल्सो क्वाइट होपफुल राइट. इज द इंडियन हॉकी टीम डूइंग वेल?
यस व्हाई नॉट. सी दे विल श्योरली दे विल क्वालिफाई फॉर द क्वार्टर फाइनल्स. उसके बाद नॉकआउट्स में यू हैव टू गिव योर बेस्ट.
कुछ भी हो सकता
है. अगर आपका बेस्ट है हो सकता है आप नॉकआउट्स में पहले राउंड में ही बाहर हो जाए तो वो एक रिस्क है. बट यस हो सकता है, बिल्कुल हो सकता है. हॉकी मेडल को आप 12वां मेडल उनको भी गिन लीजिए.
Sure. Okay, if you want Rahul, India to get lots of medals, remember to like the video in the comments. Make your predictions.
Absolutely.
Please in the comments make your predictions. Kitne medals aa sakte hain? And of course a big like for Rahul Rawat who is with us. He's from the India Today Group. He's a fantastic journalist. He's
Thank
sitting
you,
in Tokyo
much.
In his hotel room right now, thankfully isolating. Hence we have time to do this with him. But please subscribe, bell icon, and share with like-minded people. Okay, back to you, Jambu.
हाँ राहुल आपने नीरज चोपड़ा की बात की आवर मेडल होपफुल इन जैवलिन नाउ ही इज पार्ट ऑफ द आर्मी कंटिंजेंट आई बिलीव देर आर 16 पार्टिसिपेंट्स लिटरली फ्रॉम द इंडियन आर्मी इज दिस द लार्जेस्ट नंबर एवर और हैव दे ऑलवेज सेंट एथलीट्स एज पार्ट ऑफ द कंटिंजेंट एंड आई एम जस्ट नॉट अवेयर ऑफ इट
So, Rajyavardhan Singh Rathaur was
yes,
from army.
Yes,
then your silver medalist. Then your silver medalist in London, Vijay Kumar. Not many people actually thought that he could end up on the podium, but he managed to win a silver medal. And individually, if you see till that time, of course, Sushil Kumar won a silver in that particular London Olympics, and Rathaur a silver medalist. So he was only the third. Silver medalist, and perhaps even till now, just four Indians have individually won silver medal. So Army, Army has produced many athletes over a long time. Milkha Singh, of course, he was. How can we forget the legendary flying Sikh Milkha Singh? He was also from Army. So yeah.
Fabulous. And, so I know that there are 16 of them and a lot of them taking part in the athletics. So, I mean, sure, we have Neeraj Chopra, but there's a lot of them in the race walk, long in the 3,000 meters.
Right.
What long is our... I don't think we've ever won a medal in that area. And that's as far as the bigger Olympics picture goes, that's a large medal haul. I mean, athletic events are just that many. Do we stand some sort of chance in that area, aside from the ones that we just discussed?
Neeraj Chopra, to an extent, Kamalpreet Kaur, she is also a discus thrower. Then Seema Antil would be competing in her fifth Olympics. So these are the only three athletes who can come anywhere close to, or you can think. So I am guessing Neeraj Chopra, of course, will compete in the final. Then you have Seema Antil, a discus thrower, and Kamalpreet Kaur, another discus thrower. So both these should also qualify for the finals. But I doubt if that can happen, that they can win a medal. Surely they can, but will they? I don't know. Neeraj Chopra, going by his form, you know, if you see his season's record this year, so ahead of him, there is a German, Johannes Vetter. You can just write it down that he is going to win a gold medal because he is in a league of his own. Then you have a Polish guy. Then you have somebody from Trinidad Tobago. So these are the three athletes who have. So this guy, Johannes Vetter, is somewhere around 96 and above meters. Then you have these three guys. So Neeraj Chopra's season best is 88.06 meters, which is very, very good. If he's going to throw, the spear to that distance, he's definitely winning a medal. But I think Olympics mein aapka score thoda sa kam aayega.
And are you fascinated by the fact that is bar alag-alag cheezon mein there are like first-time athletes. Like we have a fencer, Bhavani Devi, who took up fencing as a kid and her parents took many, many loans and you know, to support her passion. And now she's reached the Olympics. But fencing, are you now fascinated about like checking out some sports that perhaps earlier you never covered? Like you're excited about now, hey, I'm going to get to cover fencing because, you know, Bhavani is there.
Absolutely. There is always a first time. And, you know, this is how a sport actually grows in a country. You know, Deepa Karmakar, first Indian gymnast to compete at the Olympics. Now you have another female, another girl, Pranati Nayak, who's going to compete in this Olympics. These are the stories that actually popularize the sport in a particular region. Today, not a lot of people would even know the rules. May not even know about fencing the sport.
Correct.
And this is how you learn. This is how you learn. You know, an Indian doing well. Deepa Karmakar, she became a rage.
Yeah,
absolutely.
She finished fourth, in fact, the last Olympics.
Yeah.
But that sort of comes back to your point about we're in love with sports persons and not the sport.
Exactly.
I mean, what did we know about gymnastics aside from literally YouTube videos and things like that until Deepa came along? Same will probably apply to fencing. But the idea is, when you do it from ground up, then everybody knows the sport, everybody is aware of the contestants within it and things like that, versus us just being random cricket loving nation.
Absolutely. Or exactly. In fact, a lot of people, Nadia Comaneci, the greatest gymnast
in the world.
In this country, people got to know about her only through Deepa Karmakar, because the Prudhonova vault that she used to do, this girl, Deepa Karmakar, not many would experiment, because it's a life-threatening stunt or vault. So that is how people got to know who's the greatest ever gymnast in the world. So this is actually, but what you said, Deepa Karmakar, is everything good about gymnastics now? So we have to get things in order so that we can have more Deepa Karmakars, more Pranati Nayaks, more Ashish Kumar, the guy who won your Asian Games medal, the boy. Ashish Kumar, today, even he is lost.
Yes, that's true.
Every Olympics, you kind of pray, you know that India is a country of over a billion people. We're always lamenting about the fact that you're a billion plus people, why can't we get more medals? And we also know that it's we're a poor nation and, we just don't have the facilities. Our athletes literally become medal winners on their own merit and on their own dumb. And they go against all odds, their families sacrifice so much for them to be able to pursue the sport. And every Olympics, you hope, is better. And there's been more support. Are we finally there, at least? Like, can we say, okay, now there is at least some state support and there is some government support, or there is still miles to go?
No, government support is definitely there. I won't say, because, government does pump in a lot of money. The problem is whether that money is being directed, to its logical conclusion or where it should be. That's the issue. Government would announce every budget. You would, kitna ek tarikh ko hota hai, do ko hota hai, I think first or second April ya Feb. March mein aise hota budget. Feb mein hota hai, right? Feb, so anyway, you would get to know. Is bar bhi I was just trying to figure out kya sports ko kitna sports budget mila. So that is how I was just, so whether that money is going to the right individual or to the right facility, so that is what we have to see. Paisa to aap jitna bhi dal do, aap ye hai ki bhai usme schemes, ek to ye bhi hota hai na, riders bhi hote hain, ye is scheme mein dal diya, wo us scheme mein dal diya, wo us scheme mein dal diya, us scheme ka result kya hai? Tops mein hum bahut dekhte hain, tops mein logon ko aise paise mil jate hain. Tops is your target Olympic podium scheme that was launched by the government some years ago. So, usme, but wo athlete, so you have to see ki wo paisa ja kahan raha hai.
It's nice not to have our athletes at least complaining about like joote nahi hai and baggage nahi hai, I don't have the right gear and all. At least that those days are gone. And now apparently the food has also improved and they're very pleased because there's like chole bature, butter chicken and paneer and naan for our athletes.
Ye kahan ki baat kar rahe hain aap? Yahan Tokyo ya?
Tokyo. Apparently they're happy ki organizers ne bahut bahut badhiya like North Indian khana like rakha hai sabke liye.
वो है इफ आई रिमेंबर करेक्टली लास्ट टाइम तो एक इंडियन कुक भी था रियो ओलंपिक्स में बट यहाँ पे तो है अभी मैं बात हो रही थी उन्होंने पूछा खाने में क्या क्या बोल रहे दालें हैं छोले भटूरे भी हैं और बैंगन है भिंडी है आलू है ये है वो है तो मैंने कहा भाई तुम ओलंपिक्स में गए हो शादी में गए हो तो वही वो है खैर जिसको खाने होते हैं वो छोले भटूरे तो अवॉइड ही कर रहे हैं ये है कि एज फार एज these athletes are concerned, वो ठीक है एक टावर जिसको इनको मिला हुआ है बस they have to just be careful. उसी टावर में साउथ अफ्रीकन कंटिजेंट भी रुका हुआ है और ओलंपिक गेम्स में जो भी केसेस आए थे वो साउथ अफ्रीकन सॉकर टीम से आए थे जिसमें उनके दो फुटबॉलर्स प्लेयर्स और एक उनका जो वीडियो एनालिस्ट है he got tested positive. Of course, the video analyst wasn't staying in the village. फिर उनके जो रग्बी सेवेंस की जो टीम है उसका कोच भी पॉजिटिव हो गया so they just have to be careful but wo flows alag alag hain but okay. Still dining hall jo hota hai you dining hall I guess wo ek hi hai usme so you have to be a little careful
fair enough
and have you
ye hai apne athletes don't worry
ठीक है,
है ना, चंगा,
and उनके जो पलंग हैं आपने चेक किए हैं, बिकॉज दे वर इन द न्यूज रिसेंटली के the athletes and the anti-sex beds which are made of cardboard.
Cardboard वाले recycled beds. And there was this big...
ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, I think वो इनफैक्ट उस पर क्लैरिफिकेशन भी कर दिया IOC ने, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमिटी ने भी. ओ दे आर वेरी स्टर्डी, सो यू कैन यूज देम फॉर एनी अदर पर्पसेस आल्सो.
करेक्ट,
मतलब मल्टी एक्टिविटी बेड्स हैं.
ओ सो
ठीक है
राहुल, व्हाट आर यू लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू एंड व्हाट वुड यू रेकमेंड लाइक एज अ ले पर्सन, एंड वी रियली वांट टू सपोर्ट ऑल द एथलीट्स, दे रियली दिस ओलंपिक्स फॉर श्योर दे हैव गॉन थ्रू इवन एक्स्ट्रा स्ट्रेस देन द नॉर्मल यू नो times that they have to go through. What would you recommend? How do we, like, what should we watch? Every day should we just check out random sports? Is that what you would recommend? Or only watch the ones where maybe there's a medal? What would you tell us to do to support the athletes?
See, look, what I am looking forward to, first thing that I am looking forward to is to get out of my room first. To just get done with this quarantine. Second thing that I'm excited about most is the first day of competition, that is 24th of July, where India can actually win medals. And trust me, mujhe nahi pata ki India mein abhi kaisa hype hai. Just because, you know, I am a sports journalist, so mujhe I have to be aware aur main rehta hun in sab cheezon mein. But I don't know Olympics ko leke India mein kitna kaisa mahol hai. But trust me, if you win even a single medal on day one, you will see how the momentum shifts. How
correct.
Everybody in India, every Tom, Dick and Harry, from Prime Minister to a Panwala to everybody will be talking about only and only Olympics. Aapki us waqt India Sri Lanka ki series khatm hone wali hogi, cricket series, and the England series jo hai against England from 4th of August. Yes, 4th of August se wo pehla test match hai. Main bata raha hu, everything will take a back seat. That if you're Saurabh Chaudhary, you know, these are stories. हम बात कर रहे हैं, आई एम श्योर आपने भी रिसर्च करी होगी जब आप ओलंपिक्स पे बात करने आए हैं कि यार ये सौरभ चौधरी के बारे में थोड़ा और जान लेते हैं, और जान लेते हैं, और जान लेते हैं. द मोमेंट ही विंस अ मेडल, मतलब उसकी पूरी उसका बायोडाटा
विल बी आउट
देयर, एंड पीपल वुड वॉन्ट टू नो अबाउट हिम, पीपल वुड वॉन्ट टू नो एवरीथिंग अबाउट हिम. उसके पैंट कौन सी कलर की है, उसका घर में उसका एक रूम है, आई बीन टू हिज हाउस, उसका एक रूम यहाँ है, उसका ये वाला डोर खुला रहता है, यहाँ पे उसका वो टारगेट है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस इज द रूम, यहाँ पे उसका टारगेट है और ये दरवाजा है, तो ये दरवाजा खुला होगा, वो दूसरे रूम जो सामने होगा वहां से प्रैक्टिस करता था जब वो छोटा था, छोटा इन द सेंस, हाँ यस, घर पे,
ही इज ओनली 19
मेरिट में,
अभी भी तो छोटा है, मेरिट में,
हाँ, सो एंड आई एम ट्रस्ट मी बिकॉज मोमेंटम और आपका जो इंटरेस्ट एंड एक्साइटमेंट जो है वो सारा ओलंपिक्स की तरफ ड्राइव हो जाएगा, एंड आई होप दैट हैपेंस बिकॉज हमें ये चाहिए. आप हर कोई किसी को देखता है तभी दूसरा बनता है. बजरंग फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बजरंग हालांकि ये है, बजरंग यू नो हैज ऑलवेज आइडलाइज्ड, यूज्ड टू आइडलाइज योगेश्वर दत्त, बट जिस दिन बजरंग ने छत्रसाल स्टेडियम में एंटर किया था, उससे आई थिंक एक महीने बाद या दो तीन महीने बाद सुशील कुमार छत्रसाल स्टेडियम से ही ओलंपिक मेडल, बीजिंग में ओलंपिक मेडल जीत गया था 2008 में. तो बजरंग ने भी वहां पे इतने हजारों सौ रेसलर्स थे, बट बजरंग वहां सबको लगा होगा यार हमें भी ये करना है, वी ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू डू. सो दीज आर योर परहैप्स मोटिवेशन, इंस्पिरेशन, रोल मॉडल. सो दैट इज परहैप्स, जैसे मैंने बोला ना, वी आर स्पोर्ट्स पर्सन लविंग नेशन. तो आप चाहे जैसे भी, आपको मेडल चाहिए एंड रिजल्ट इज, चाहे आप किसी को आइडलाइज करके बनाओ या आप अपनी मेहनत से करो, एंड ऑफ द डे ये है. बाकी ये है कि 8th ऑफ ऑगस्ट होपफुली वी डू एंड अप विनिंग दैट मेनी मेडल्स, ऑल्दो आई एम नॉट टू श्योर कि हम कितने मेडल्स जीतेंगे. चार मुझे लगता है मिनिमम होने चाहिए, अगर चार से नीचे आपने किया ना, फिर तो आप मतलब हो गया काम, मतलब इट कैन नॉट हैपन.
अच्छा, देन फिंगर्स क्रॉस, इंशाल्लाह डेफिनेटली 4 एंड अबव, एंड And day one, which is on the 24th of July, everything goes well for all our athletes. Rahul, you have been absolutely fantastic. Thank you very, very much. Jaggu, do you have a last question for him?
No, my last is not a question. It's a point, as a matter of fact. Rahul, once the Olympics wrap, we were at such a fun time having this conversation with you. We want to do the wrap with you in August.
Anytime, sir. Anytime. Anytime.
मजा आ गया.
अगर मैं इंडिया में क्वारंटीन कर लिया तब भी कर लेंगे, नहीं किया तब भी करेंगे. बिल्कुल. It was actually pleasure's all mine. In fact, I really enjoyed the conversation. और मैंने शायद से थोड़ा ज्यादा भी बोल दिया होगा.
नहीं
आप
नहीं,
दोनों ने उतना मिलके नहीं बोला होगा जितना मैंने अकेले बोल दिया होगा, मुझे लग रहा है.
But they were pearls of wisdom.
Yeah, and you're the expert for us.
अरे नहीं, कोई expert नहीं है इंडिया में. Nobody, everybody is an expert.
No, but you have genuinely got us, and I know our viewers right now are like, yeah, I wasn't too sure मैं Olympics को follow करूंगी या नहीं करूंगा, but now we're like quite like हाँ, okay, चलो. Now we feel like we know the athletes a little bit.
So, बिल्कुल करना है आपको ओलंपिक्स को फॉलो, टेलीविजन पे, ऑनलाइन, एनीवेयर एंड एवरीवेयर. एंड यू नीड टू रिक्वेस्ट, आस्क, फोर्स योर सब्सक्राइबर्स एंड योर फॉलोअर्स टू एक्चुअली चीयर फॉर इंडिया. एंड जस्ट होप दैट वी डू एंड अप विद द बेस्ट एवर मेडल हॉल, क्योंकि उनको, उन तक आवाज जाती है. ऐसा नहीं कि उनको आवाज नहीं जाती, सब पता लगता है उनको कि कहां क्या हो रहा है. ट्रस्ट मी.
बिल्कुल राइट, बिल्कुल राइट. We will 100% support the team. I mean, what other option is there?
You have to watch them also. You have to monitor their progress also.
बिल्कुल.
क्योंकि वो जो बोलते हैं ना, वो कभी कभार हम तो सोशल मीडिया बंद कर दिया, हमने ये कर दिया, कुछ नहीं होता सब. वो क्रिकेटर्स भी बोलते हैं, हम तो ध्यान नहीं देते, ये नहीं करते, सब
देते हैं,
सब खबर रहती है. और क्या,
तुम ट्रेंड कर रहे थे and all they like to hear that. All right, Rahul, thank you very much. Wishing Team India, actually, well, all teams in the world, all the athletes, all the best. Thank you very much. You stay safe and we will follow your adventures on Aajtak, on India Today. We've been, telling everybody your Twitter handle or not. Rahul Rawat, please follow him. He's also on YouTube. All his links, etc. will be
thank
in the description.
Thank you very much.
Our pleasure. Thanks so much for doing this.
Thank you. And dear viewer, thank you very much for watching it so far. If you've enjoyed our conversation and want us to do more of these, remember, like the video in the comments, tell us, what you think. Remember to subscribe, bell icon, and share with like-minded people. Thank you. We'll see you very, very soon. Okay, bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.